Welcome to students once again. Now we are to discuss about the remaining part of the Indian philosophy point. Here we seen that in this slide, the first point is the most common question on the which is the schools of the Vedanta are divided as what is the nature of the relation between the self and God. The Vedanta is divided into two parts, that is the in self and God, that is the Jiva and Brahman. It is see in detail in future slide. First point, Shankara Vedanta, that is Advaita Vedanta. Shankaracharya was the greatest philosopher among the Indian thinkers. We know the what is the importance of the Shankaracharya in the Hindu religion, and he also known the greatest philosopher in the Indian thinkers. He emphasizes the monastic tendency in the Upanishads and develop into a systematic Advaitvada. He emphasizes the reality of unconditional and unqualified, that is Nirguna Brahman, and regards God, the individual souls and the world as appearances due to identifiable principle called cosmic nescience, that is the Maya, which is the neither real nor unreal but is indefinable. Next, the Atman. According to Shankaracharya, the Atman is the universal self. It is the Brahman, the absolute, the supreme reality. Jiva, that is the meaning of self. It is the individual or empirical self. It is the Atman, limited by the body, the sense organs, manas, buddhi, and the likes, which are its limiting agents. Atman is the transcendental, metaphysical self. Jiva is the empirical, phenomenal self. The Atman is of the nature of pure consciousness. It is the eternally pure conscious and liberated. It is the eternal, unchangeable, absolute, formless, one supreme reality. It is different from the empirical self, but the empirical self, it is not different from it. That is the Atman. It is different from empirical self, but empirical self is not different from the Atman. The Atman is the reality. The Atman is the reality. Next, the empirical self, that is the Jiva. The empirical self is the knower, enjoyer, and active agent. It acquires merits and demerits and experiences their fruits. It subjects to transmigration, lives an embodied life in empirical world, and is capable of bondage and the liberation. Though it is not different from the Atman, the supreme self, and immortal in its essential nature. Mortality is attributed to it owing to its action due to nescience. Nescience is nothing but the Maya. Next point is the concept of Brahman. Brahman is the only ontological reality in Shankara Vedanta. Brahman is existence, knowledge, and bliss. Brahman is limitless and infinite. Brahman is the limitless and infinite. Brahman is the eternally accomplished being. It does not change, increase, and decrease, grow, and develop. Next, Ishvara, that is the God. God is the determined Brahman in Shankara Vedanta. He is not unconditional, indeterminate, attributeless Brahman. He is the Brahman conditioned by cosmic nescience, that is the Maya. Though Brahman is attributeless, it is said to be endowed with empirical attributes for the sake of prayer. Next, Maya, that is the Avidya. Shankaracharya uses the Maya and Avaidya, the two words, of synonymously. Brahman conditioned by Maya is Ishwara, that is the God. Maya is his power or energy, the source of the names and forms, which are modified into the phenomena of the world and which are neither real nor unreal, but identifiable. Next, Maya is cosmic nescience, that is the Maya. It is an identifiable principle. Maya is identifiable principle. It is the ontological unreal, since Brahman is the only ontological reality. Maya is the ontological unreal, but the Brahman is the ontological reality. But it is not absolutely unreal like hare's horn. It is the real enough to project the multiple world of appearances. Next, Ramanuja Vedanta, that is the Vijistadvaita. Ramanujacharya was the chief propounder of the doctrine of qualified monism, that is the Vijistadvaita. He criticized Shankaracharya monism and established the ontological reality of the God. He criticized the Shankaracharya monism and established the own ontological reality of the God. The individual souls and the world, and regarded the soul, the world, as attributes or modes of the God. Then, what is the concept of the Brahman, or that is the God? The Brahman is the supreme person endowed with innumerable supreme and auspicious qualities and devoid of all impure qualities. Brahman is the known as supreme person in the philosophy, and is the innumerable supreme and auspicious qualities, are very too much or great qualities, and divided into all impure qualities. He is the infinite reality by nature and qualities. There is no other supreme reality. He is the topest or topmost supreme reality, and there is no other supreme reality. This, he is the possessor of truth or reality, knowledge and bliss. It is the possessor of truth or reality and knowledge and the bliss. Next, the self, that is the jiva and consciousness. The jiva is the individual self. Jiva is the meaning as the individual self. It is a different from the body, life, the sense organs, mind and intellect. It is a different from the psychophysical organism. The jiva, it is a different from the body, life, the sense organs and mind and intellect. That is different also from the psychophysical organism. It is a knower, the enjoyer and active agent. Self or jiva is knower, the enjoyer and active agent. It is a self-humanous and manifests itself without the aid of knowledge. It is the abode, the knowledge, and has attribute to consciousness. Here we the complete the chapter of the second chapter of the EITK. In this chapter, if you have to, I have given the assignments in next video. Thank you so much.